Good morning, students of class 6. Please turn to page number 82. I remember I taught till respiration, but the last paragraph was left. So students, please be attentive and take a pencil, and when I ask you to underline, please underline. Page number 82. The third paragraph. Some animals which do not have gills or lungs breathe in other ways. Earthworms breathe through their body surface, while insects breathe through holes in their bodies called spiracles. Plants breathe through special openings present in the leaves called stomata. Respiration happens during day and night, while photosynthesis happens during the day. Remember students, during the daytime, the stomata opens and the carbon dioxide diffuses through the stomata. So, photosynthesis occurs during the daytime. That means in the presence of sunlight. In the absence of sunlight, photosynthesis will not take place. So, during dark, or at night, the photosynthesis will not take place. But respiration, on the other hand, will occur during the day, during the night. That means respiration can occur in the daytime as well as in the dark. But photosynthesis will occur only in the presence of sunlight. Non-living things neither breathe nor respire. Now excretion, you know what is excretion students? The removal of the waste products from the body is called excretion. Please underline students the definition of metabolism, which is printed in italics. The breaking down of substances in the body for the release of energy or for the growth of the body is called metabolism. Let me tell you one thing students, metabolism is of two types. Anabolism and catabolism. Now anabolism is constructive, whereas catabolism is destructive. Okay? Underline the definition of excretion printed in italics. The process by which waste material is removed from the body is called excretion. Come to page number 83. In plants, the waste products are excreted either as gases through the stomata or as gum and resin. Non-living things do not excrete waste as they neither eat nor metabolize food. Reproduction. Children, please underline. Living organisms are capable of creating more organisms of their own kind. For example, an amoeba, underline this. For example, an amoeba. Now, amoeba, you cannot see this with naked eye. You have to use a microscope. An amoeba splits into two daughter cells which become independent individuals. This kind of reproduction, where new cells are formed from cells of a single parent, is called asexual reproduction. Underline, in some plants, a part of the plant is used to grow a new plant having exactly the same characteristics as the parent plant. This is called vegetative reproduction. Rose and ginger reproduce vegetatively. In higher plants and animals, a new organism develops from the union of cells from two individuals, a male and a female. This is called sexual reproduction. Non-living organisms do not reproduce. So children, you have to understand what is asexual reproduction, what is vegetative reproduction, and what is sexual reproduction. Okay. You will turn to page number 84. There are some adaptations. You will underline the adaptations. First, you will underline the definition. Adaptation is the process by which a living organism changes to survive and reproduce in its environment. Actually, students, adaptation is very much essential for a species to survive. Yes, students, you see, the dinosaurs became extinct. Why? Because they could not adapt. Okay? when there will be climatic changes, when there will be shortage of food, or when the conditions are not favorable, you will see that many animals go for hibernation. Okay, so why hibernation? In order to protect themselves. Okay, now sometimes what happens, climatic changes occur, then sometimes there is shortage of food, so you need to adapt yourself, and if you are not able to adapt, then a species will become extinct. That means a species will not be able to exist any longer if that particular species is not adapted to the changes in the surroundings. If a species is not adapted to the climatic changes, if a species is not adapted to the changes in the surroundings, then the species will have to become extinct. The following are some adaptations shown by different animals. A polar bear has thick fur to help it stay warm in the cold polar regions. Children, fur, what is fur? Fur is actually something that helps the polar bear to keep it warm. Fur contains a lot of trapped air, and air is a bad conductor of heat. It does not allow the heat from the body of the polar bear to flow out, and thus the polar bears are able to survive in the cold polar regions. It is because of the fur, because fur contains a lot of trapped air, and air is a bad conductor of heat. So since air is a bad conductor of heat, what happens? The heat from the body of the polar bear does not flow out, and thus the polar bears are able to survive. A hawk has a sharp hooked beak for tearing its prey. A woodpecker uses its long pointed beak to drill into the bark of trees to find insects. A dog adapts to warm weather by shedding its hair. Insect-eating plants grow chiefly in areas where the soil lacks an adequate supply of nitrogen. Adequate means sufficient. These plants trap and digest insects to meet their nutritional requirements. Insectivorous plants. Yes, there are some plants that eat insects. So these plants are also called insectivorous plants. These plants grow in those areas where there is deficiency of nitrogen in the soil. You will see, students, that nitrogen is one of the main components of protein. So in absence of nitrogen, you cannot synthesize protein. So these plants, in order to get the nutritional requirement, grow. In order to obtain the nutritional requirements, these plants trap the insects and digest the insects to make up the deficiency of nitrogen. Lifespan, underline. The period over which an organism lives from birth to death is called its lifespan. For example, the lifespan of humans is 70 to 80 years, and a horse's lifespan is about 30 years.